Now you're in menopause, your ovaries are declining, you're not getting as much estrogen, but your hypothalamus is registering that this decline and is giving you a hot flash. So we want to make sure we're cleaning up the neurons in that hypothalamus area. We also want to make sure that your ovaries are working at their best. And there is one fast that can accomplish both of those things. Dr. Mindy here, and on this video, we're going through hot flashes. So those of you that have reached out to us and said, oh my gosh, how are these hot flashes happening to me? Why are they happening? Fasting's maybe making it worse. Maybe fasting's not helping it. I'm gonna give you on this video five things that you need to think about in order to use fasting as a tool to be able to overcome those hot flashes. And as always, if you're new to my channel, I just want to say welcome. We are on a mission, my team and I, to get 1 million people here this year so that we can teach you why fasting is so incredible, why it can heal you, and it's free, and it doesn't take a lot of time. Super cool hack that our body responds well to. Please hit the notification button so that you get all the videos. And those of you that share this out to the world, thank you. I love being on this journey with you guys. Okay, you ready? Five things. And I'm gonna start with some informational things that help you understand why you're getting hot flashes. So after 40, I want you to remember that estrogen declines. So now in your 40s, your estrogen's doing this. It's going up, down, up, down. But for the most part, it's steadily declining. This decline in estrogen triggers the hypothalamus in the brain, and the hypothalamus in the brain controls temperature. So as estrogen goes down, it triggers the hypothalamus. The hypothalamus goes, oh my God, we have to heat this body up, and it'll start to create an elevated hot flash. So you are getting your hot flashes because of a decline in estrogen. The second thing I want you to know is that you have three types of estrogen. One is a protective estrogen, and two are harmful estrogens. One of those two in particular is cancer-causing estrogens. So we want to make sure, if you already have this decline going on, I want to make sure that you're bringing up the good estrogens, the protective ones, and you're minimizing the bad ones, and that you're supporting organs that help to break estrogen down. So what does that look like in action? 2-OH is our helpful estrogen, and you guys could find this on a Dutch test. If you've run a Dutch test, this is the easiest place to see this, but the 2-OH is the most helpful, and you can get this through a lot of leafy green vegetables. You can get it through flaxseed oil. You can even get it through coffee. So make sure that you're upping this is not a 5-cup-a-day coffee experience, but I want you to up your good coffee, maybe a cup or two. You don't need to go more than that. Make sure it's mold-free and pesticide-free. I want you to think about more around your leafy greens and something like Andreas seed oils, where you can take flaxseed oil, a cold compressed flaxseed oil, put it in a tablespoon and just have a couple of scoops of it a day, and now you are bringing your estrogen levels up. Now, if you're listening to this and you're like, what the heck is she talking about? I've put together a menopausal survival guide. So don't worry, everything I'm telling you here is gonna be in the survival guide, plus all my favorite hacks for menopause. So just put menopause survival guide in the comments and my team will make sure you get a link to that. It's a free survival guide for you. So we wanna make sure we're bringing up the helpful ones with the foods I just talked about, and we wanna minimize the harmful ones. Bad 4-OH, the harmful one is coming in from toxins. So make sure you're minimizing your toxic load. And then the third estrogen I want you to think about is what we call 16-OH. And this particular estrogen is broken down in the liver. So I want you to be very mindful of your liver. So your habits like alcohol and your medications, especially pain relievers like acetaminophen, those can be very damaging. So I want to make sure that you're keeping your liver damaging habits down and that you're promoting the foods that you need to be leaning into. I'll go through more in a moment, but you want to be promoting more of those foods that raise the good estrogens. Okay, now Which fats? Third thing I want to tell you is which fats. Okay, when we look at estrogen, we've got to think about what we call the HPO axis. So hypothalamus, pituitary, and ovaries. Now you're in menopause, your ovaries are declining, you're not getting as much estrogen, but your hypothalamus is registering that this decline and is giving you a hot flash. So we want to make sure we're cleaning up the neurons in that hypothalamus area. We also want to make sure that your ovaries are working at their best. And there is one fast that can accomplish both of those things, and that's an autophagy fast. The fecal cells around the outside of your ovaries are very sensitive to autophagy. They're programmed for autophagy. So more 17-hour fasts, lean into that so that we can get those ovaries healing and doing their best as they're exiting out. Then the hypothalamus. This is what's registering the decline in estrogen. So we need it to just calm down. We need it to be healthy. So if we lean into autophagy fasting, we can repair the neurons in that part of your brain. Number one fast for hot flashes is autophagy fasting. Now, the second fast that I really like for using estrogen is a 24-hour fast. The reason I like the 24-hour fast is because it helps to repair your microbiome. And I've said this before on videos, you have a whole set of bacteria that break estrogen down. So every 24-hour fast that you throw in there, what you're doing is you're creating this terrain in your gut that is going to help you use the estrogen, the little bit of estrogen that you're getting, it's going to help you use that estrogen more so that it doesn't get stored as fat, it gets stored in brain tissue or nervous tissue. We want you to use the little bit of estrogen. If you don't use it, you'll lose it. If you lose it, the hypothalamus gets mad and gives you a hot flash. So more 17 hours, more 24-hour, once a week, 24-hour fast would be incredible. Okay, what about food? So now you're like, hey, okay, I got this. I should be doing 17 hours, maybe 3 to 4 times a week. Maybe one day a week, I'm doing a 24-hour fast. One day a week, I like you guys to feast. Well, what do I eat when I'm not fasting? And for hot flashes, you really want to support estrogen production. So you want to help to bring up the good estrogens. You want foods that will help you break down the harmful estrogens. So here's a list, and I'm going to go fast, okay? The brassica family, so Brussels sprouts, kale, broccoli, artichokes, leafy greens, onions, garlics, beets, carrots, flax seeds, fermented foods, berries, orange and red peppers. These are foods that will help you bring up the good estrogen and break down the bad estrogen. It's also really important that you stay hydrated, so make sure you're getting 6 to 8 glasses of clean water a day. And then the last thing, this is the one that you really have to focus in. I probably should have started the whole video on this one, which is avoid the standard American diet. The bad oils, the refined flours, the refined sugars, this is going to make you your estrogen, your good estrogens plummet, your bad estrogens go up. It's going to contribute to more of your hot flashes. So avoid the standard American diet and add in the foods that I just mentioned. Okay, last thing, and remember, if you're like, oh, this is really good, I need more hacks like this, my menopausal survival guide, just put that in the comments and we'll make sure that you get a copy of it. But the last major point I want to make, which is that not only do you need your liver healthy, so watch some of those liver depleting habits like alcohol drinking, I also want you to focus in on just overall gut health. So staying away from antibiotics and antibiotic-rich meat. Antibiotics, you know, that's a conversation between you and your doctor, but we really want to minimize those. Should be life, you know, threatening moments that you lean into antibiotics. So be very cautious about how much antibiotics you're ingesting, how much of the antibacterial soaps you're putting on your hands, how much of the antibiotic-rich meats you're eating, because that is destroying these bacteria that will break estrogen down. And then add in the foods I talked, but you can also add in some more polyphenol foods, like, you know, every once in a while, a glass of dry farm wines would not be the end of the world. And we have a very specific style of wine that's non-toxic. It's in the survival guide, but you could also put dry farm wines in the comments and my team will give you a link to that. But make sure if you are drinking that it's beneficial. Like, I just found out, this is really interesting, I just found out today in researching for this video that Cab Franc, that grape, has the highest amount of resveratrol, and resveratrol will help you raise the good estrogen and break down the bad. So, you know, something as simple as a dry farm wine glass every once in a while could actually be beneficial. Too much, not so beneficial. So liver and gut, pay attention to your microbiome, and again, use fasting. Lean into these autophagy and the 24-hour fast. Lean into the eating the foods that I mentioned, and absolutely you can manage your hot flashes using these techniques. Last thing, those of you that bought the book, so it's coming out next week, and just really excited for your support, so I want to start off by saying thank you. When you get the book, I would love for you guys to pick up the book, take a picture with it, and put hashtag Menopause Reset on social media. We will find it. I am also on a mission to rebrand menopause. Menopause doesn't have to be getting old and slowing down. Menopause could be that you're actually stepping into the best moment of your life with the best sleep and the best moods and the best body that you've ever created. And that's what this book is helping you do. So, as always, you guys are awesome, and I hope that helps.